Have fun, guys.
Good luck.
Okay, just because you said so.
Yeah. I think I'm going to put it in gear one to start this time.
Flag.
On your left. Clear left.
Well done, Sean. Good start.
Right side. Clear right.
Sixth place. Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate.
Which side do you want to go on, John?
How about that side?
Yellow flag. The car ahead has just done it. 121.3.
Yeah.
Fastest lap for Smith, 121.0. The gap behind is now 0.9. That lap time was 124.3.
That grass looked at me funny.
11 seconds.
Go on my right side, whoever's behind Jay.
Your right sides are cold.
Left side, clear left.
Has just done a 120.6.
Who replaced all our rubber tires with Hot Wheels plastic tires before the race?
P8. Alright Sean, we've gone out of track limits, keep it between the lines, your tyre temperatures look good.
Fuck, my VR blacked out.
Yellow flag.
I think we lost Kevin.
Heard something about VR going bad.
You're gaining on this guy. The gap's now 7.1 seconds. The window opens in 2 minutes.
I'm on track, but I reset the pits, and so now I'm...
Okay.
Just done a 124.1. That's your fastest lap. Pit window open in 1 minute.
Oh, that's not the break point at all, is it? Oh, that was my fault. Oh, dang it. The car just did not turn.
Yellow flag, caution. window is open. Tire temps are all fine. Okay, Sean, you've used half your fuel.
Oops.
The guy behind's really new in. The gap's now 19 seconds. Okay, Sean, 10 minutes of fuel remaining. Seconds. Yellow flag. just done a 123.3. Behind's catching. The gap's now 10 seconds. Sector 1 is 1.3 seconds off the pace. Front is now 7.8 seconds. That was a 122.4. Okay, Sean, we estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining. Just cut the track. Your right tires are cold. Behind is reeling you in. The gap is now 7.4 seconds. The leader, Smith, is pitting. Nine minutes remaining. Yellow flag, watch out. Pit window opens after 10 minutes. There's no significant damage. We estimate 2 minutes of fuel left, 4.7 litres per lap. It looks like we'll need to add 131 litres to get to the end. The tyre rail looks fine, mate. Your front tyres are cold. The brake temperatures look good. The gap ahead is now 10 seconds.
Clear to the right.
Behind is pitting. Well done, Sean. This is terrific. Exactly what we came here for. P5. Very little fuel left. Coming to the pits at the end of this lap. Box this lap. Leader's pitting now. Patterson is now leading. We're running on fumes, mate. In this lap, box this lap. What's your speed limit in the pits?
You didn't have to give that up, Jay.
You should have plenty of space on the exit.
It's okay, it's my first race back.
P7, a few seconds
behind. I don't want to mess anybody up.
Position.
Appreciate him.
Car behind's pitting now. It exits clear.
Alright, I'm done. That's
your headset.
Headset
give up.
Yeah. I just can't. Same spot both times. I don't know what's going on.
The leader, Patterson, is pitting. Smith is now in the lead. Six. Okay, Sean, don't let this guy distract you. tire temps are all good. Was 123.4. Sector 1 is 1.6 seconds off the face. Lap time was 122.1. What's your best lap in this session? Your quickest lap. Don't be intimidated, keep it behind you. Sean, we're halfway home. We think about 16 minutes of fuel remaining. That lap was at 121.6. Behind is now 18 seconds.
That's a tricky one, isn't it, Jay?
Yeah, I usually go in too hot.
That lap time was 121.8. Just done a 121.7 yellow flag. That lap was at 122.5. Attention to track limits, please, Sean. Fine, no significant damage. Should be about 10 minutes of fuel remaining. 4.6 litres per lap. We will need to add 48 litres to get to the end of the race. We're not seeing any significant tyre wear. Your front tyres are cold. Brake temperatures look good. The gap in front is now 14 seconds. To reach the end. Tire wear looks fine, mate. You've got cold front tires. Brake temperatures are okay. The gap in front is now 15 seconds. Speed limit. We should come out into position 6. Car ahead spinning now. Your pit exit looks clear.
Well, I pulled in Austin Powers coming into the pit.
Oh no.
Blue flag.
Yeah, my first pit, I was not prepared for where the pit limiter grabbed me.
The right side tires are cold. That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes. Smith is pitting. lead is now 12 seconds.
Apparently I can unplug my headset and plug it back in and have this talking out to the game.
On your left, clear left.
We've been warned about track limits. Okay, Sean, 15 minutes left, that's 15 minutes.
Far right, clear right.
Has now decreased to 5.5. Pit window closing in 2 minutes. Thank you. window closes in 1 minute. Closed. 10 minutes remaining. 10 minutes. Is catching. The gap's now 2.8 seconds. Stewards have warned us for cutting the track. Keep it between the white lines. All right, Sean, hold your nerve. Just keep it smooth. No mistakes. Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. Got 10 minutes of fuel remaining. That was at 121.6. Yellow flag, caution.
Car right, clear right.
P6. Sean, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. The gap in front is increasing. It's now 3.1 seconds. Last lap was at 123.0. Yellow flag. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
Good one, John.
We estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining.
But don't start counting those chickens yet.
Who said I can count?
Your lap time was 122.
It's time for you to mess up one of those chicanes, my friend.
P6. We're running on fumes, mate. Please, Sean. Sixth place. There's the finish. Good drive.
Well, John, I think that ARB is your setting is better on this corner coming up. That hairpin?
Yeah, yeah.
I could not gain anything on you unless, you know, if we both took it well, you were always faster than me through that darn thing.
Yeah, and I was doing more of the inside line. Some of you guys, I don't know about you, but we're doing more of an outside, like diamonding it.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, I was entering it in third and just kind of coast past the first apex on third and then downshift into second about halfway through the corner, and it would get a slight drift around, but the car would rotate so I could get on the gas a little bit earlier. If I did it right, I had a decent time, but it was, you know, maybe 50% of the time that you're able to hit it that well, right?
Yeah, for sure. I was doing kind of the same thing, entering in third, getting second halfway, trying to carry enough speed to get to the next apex before actually getting back on throttle.
Yeah, yeah. No, that was good. And you got a good run on me off corner one and two there. A couple laps before the end there, and I tried to defend that on the inside, but there's just no hope. The outside line was maybe the better line for me to take rather than the inside, I think.
Yeah, I saw you go to the inside, and I thought, okay, well, let's see how this goes. I actually thought maybe you just gave it up,
no,
to be honest
no.
with you.
Normally, you take the inside line, right? Make the other guy drive around the
inside.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
But if I had thought about it a bit more, that corner is one where, you know, I was taking it all around the outside the whole time, and I'm more comfortable there, too. So, anyway, it was that was a good battle, though. Boy, that made it very interesting. You had a really good pit stop. I had a disastrous one. I ended up getting sideways in the at the entrance. First one was great, but second one I started to skid, and it just bumped into the wall, and I had to back up, and you know, that whole mess. So sort of screwed up that nice gap I had going for me.
Yeah, I was shocked when. I don't remember how that came out, but either I came out of the pit or you came out of the pit, and we were only separated by a second or two.
Yeah, I pitted early because I had gone off on that really slow corner where the big sand trap is, and I had gone off into the sand there, and I had to kind of get my way out of it, and it was right just before the 40-minute mark, and I thought, oh, what the heck, I'll go in. Fix the damage, you know, just a little bit of damage, but I thought, oh, let's just get a fresh start again, and yes. A fair amount there, but when I went into the pits, I was still kind of flustered and went in a little bit too hard.
Yeah, and this is one that you just have to be so careful at the entrance,
as I forewarned you. Yeah, I had damage from going off probably this exact same spot as you. And it took the damage actually longer than the tires by a second. So I had pretty good damage, I think.
Well, I guess you can't hear me. I was pushing my pit button there.
Oh, yeah. Were you able to hear me?
Oh,
okay.
Yeah. I was saying that I was appreciated having somebody to race with, even if it was, that sort of situation, because I couldn't catch Kevin or Martin at any time. They were just too fast. And Okada was a little inconsistent, so he would have been faster, but he was going off a little more. And I was kind of stuck there on my own for quite a while. And you guys were battling, I think, so that slowed you down.
Well, I was actually, I had Pasha to battle with for the first stint. And I don't remember if we, maybe even part of the second stint. I'm not sure about that. So at least it made it interesting. And then when I saw you on it, oh, okay, well, what the heck?
2 seconds, yeah, as a captain, I thought, well, actually, I'm quite happy with my performance, because I usually don't like being chased, and I make mistakes when I'm driving all by myself, and with pressure on me, it's even worse. So I was like, hey, man, you're doing pretty good here. If you can keep this going, just keep that gap around 1 second, demoralize John in that third sector there. I thought, well, I got a good shot at this, but yeah. Where you were strong, I was weaker, and I made just a tiny, tiny lift as I went around the corner one. And that gave you the run on that high speed straight. And I thought, well, I'm going to get out of the draft here so you can't draft me. But things didn't work out so well. Anyway, it was a good pass you made there. Anyway,
I trust you, and I trusted that I could hold the outside if I needed to with you on the inside, and then see who, how it worked out. But you just disappeared. you ended up behind me, was what
yeah.
I mean.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Yeah, that was awesome. That was really good racing. And I'm happy that I got the car performing a lot better now. So yeah, got some pace, and so I can mix it up with you guys now.
Well, I appreciate you finding the pace and the car setup, because it certainly benefited me.
Yeah, we have to thank them for the baseline, because that was awesome, that base setup, because you could just drive it right out of right the way he drove it at Chang, and it was quite good, and then just making a few little changes made it even better for this track. I don't think I'll deviate too much from it, because it seems to have it really dialed in.
Yeah, I was all happy to just go with his set until you offered me a little, adjustment. And like I said in my text there, I didn't know it could feel better than it already was feeling. And it was nice to feel better even.
Yeah. Those were worth about 4/10, I think you were saying, the difference in lap times.
No, that was just what I found today. And that was just changing the rear bar back and forth.
Yeah.
But no, I found, all of that, maybe even more, maybe closer to a half, I think.
Yeah.
The two setups.
I set a PB in quali, but I hadn't done any laps with low fuel, so I had no idea how the car was going to behave and whether the rake would change, or whatever. But I just thought, I'm putting 40 liters in, to qualify, so I'll just run it like that. Probably doesn't make that much difference, but I noticed that around the third lap, fourth lap, when the grip was up, my times were getting really fast, and I went, "Ooh, gee whiz, this is I can really throw this car into the corners now, and with no fear, right?" And it gave me a lot of confidence this race.
Yeah, I usually quali with full fuel, which I did again tonight.
Yeah.
But with 5 or so minutes to go, I blew a lap, and I said, you know what? I'm going to try what these guys are doing. So I put in like 36 liters, and sure enough, on this, I think it was the second lap, you know, I went green by quite a bit and finished the lap. And then my next lap, I was green by almost 6 tenths more,
yeah.
and I blew the lap.
I know. I was shocked because I gained a bunch of time at the front end, and I went, okay, yeah, I know how this turns out, but I'll keep trying it. And it stayed there and stayed there and stayed there. It was 4 tenths. And even those last two corners, which hard to get the corners leading onto the finishing straight, get those right was carrying decent speed and not going on.
Even on turn, turn one, I guess it's turn two, the, you know, pretty much flat out left after it. In practice, I'm flat out and just going for it. During the race, I was actually flat out maybe most of the time, but there were times where I just feathered it just a hair.
Yep.
Because I know what it's like not to get it right. Did it plenty of times.
Well, looking at the lap time, so in the race, we both turned 120s for our best lap. You turned a 129.28, I turned a 128.86. But if you look at the two sectors, you're stronger in sector one, so you're 2 tenths faster than me there. And then in sector three, I was about 1 tenth faster than you there. And 1 tenth faster, maybe 2 tenths in sector two. So sector two and three were my best sectors, if you just look at that one lap time.
Yeah. And I think that was pretty consistent, it seemed, when we were, you know, nose to tail, more or less.
Yeah.
I could tell you were better, especially in the third.
Third gear through that second last corner, the right-left? You know, there's the first right-left combo, which is the very tricky one where you can end up in the sand trap. And then the second one you can take a bit faster, and it's a right-left, and then it's just all that's left after that are the two big round corner, two apex corner leading onto the main straight. So do you take that in third, or do you take it in second, or shift it to second for the second half?
So I enter it in third, but hit second just as I'm before the first apex, and then I quickly go through the apex, go back to third with my, you know, full throttle, and only for a little split second, and then back to second, and then I let off and I go through the corner and you know, I nail it. So I've tried it every way I could think of, and that seemed to be the best for me.
Yeah, and the corner before, well, I stayed in third through that whole corner. I think once I might have shifted to second just because I got bogged down. And the corner before that, the right-left combo, I was going through that full thing in second. I didn't shift to first in that corner at all. So I took the second, the left, tricky left one, in still in second gear.
Oh, okay. See, I definitely, matter of fact, I almost ran into the back of you.
That was my bad. I went in too hot, a little too far past the 100 marker, and I locked up. So then I was off line to get into the corner. Yeah, that was not a good one.
Well, guess what? I followed you because you break late, so I broke late.
Yeah.
And I figured what I was going to do is, you know, go to the left and, you know, not hit you. But I was able to, you know, hunker it down fast enough and follow you through.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
We both made it. It was all good. It's just that was kind of close.
I was not worried ever. I knew you'd be fine there. But when I do something like that that's unpredictable, it always creates some angst and say, oh, geez, you know, watch out. And then the rest of the corner is kind of messed up anyway, right? So I lost a big gap there just on that one corner. But then I felt confident in that sector three, so I could get a little bit more cushion. But I knew you were going to catch me on number sector one. And the first corner, I was, I just didn't want to put it into the green every lap. Do you know what I mean? Because it's if you get too far over to the left, or you can go a little too fast in there, and then it messes the straight up. But that one there, I was pretty happy. It was fairly consistent, but definitely slower than you through there. So I think maybe your rear ARB for that. Especially that corner and the next one, that was the better way to go.
Yeah, I felt real confident through there, which unusual for me. But
yeah.
Hey, Kevin.
Hello. How was the race?
That was good, really good. John and I had a good battle towards the end, and so it was about, I don't know, John, how many laps? Well, it was from the last pit stop, so it's almost 20 minutes. We were battling very close in pace, and yeah,